Here's the deal. The Seven Wonders of the World aren't just some architectural mysteries from Indiana Jones. But we also don't have a whole lot of historical evidence telling us what they were actually like, or even which seven were wondrous enough to be on the list, as there was some disagreement among the ancient observers who listed them. One of the main descriptions of the Seven Wonders that we still have today isn't a treatise from some paragon of high reputation. It's actually a poem.
I have set eyes on the wall of lofty Babylon, on which is a road of chariots, and the statue of Zeus by the Alpheus, and the hanging gardens, and the colossus of the sun, and the huge labor of the high pyramids, and the vast tomb of Mausolus. But when I saw the house of Artemis that mounted to the clouds, those other marvels lost their brilliancy, and I said, lo, apart from Olympus, the sun never looked on aught so grand.
Though Antipater of Sidon found the walls of Babylon wondrous enough to proclaim, others were more impressed by the pharos, or lighthouse, of Alexandria, and called it a wonder. So, what were the seven wonders anyway? The pyramids of Giza are the only wonder that still exists today. They're also the oldest, built between about 2575 and 2465 BCE. Historians aren't certain what the Hanging Gardens of Babylon looked like. They could have been tiered terraces built to resemble a mountain, or just a really cool rooftop garden. This huge portrayal of the Greek god Zeus was crafted by the famous sculptor Phidias and was likely destroyed a few years after its creation, either alongside its temple in 426 BCE or in a fire at Constantinople about 50 years later. Only a few fragmented columns remain of the massive temple built about 550 BCE, and that's not just because it's super old. A few centuries after the temple was built, a madman named Herostratus burnt it almost to the ground. The Persian ruler Mausolus, who died about 353 or 352 BCE, was laid to rest in this monumental tomb adorned with sculptures by leading Greek artists. The colossal statue of the sun god Aelios didn't actually straddle the entrance to Rhodes Harbor, as a rumor suggests, but it did welcome visitors to the city for about 50 years before toppling during an earthquake. And finally, the pharos of Alexandria, built about 280 BCE. It was one of the first fully functioning lighthouses in history, making it the model for future lighthouses to come.